Blackstone Publishing presents Make a Zine, 20th Anniversary Edition. Start Your Own Underground Publishing Revolution by Joe Biel with Bill Brent. This book is read by Paul Michael Garcia. Foreword to the 20th Anniversary Edition. A zine is a love letter about the author's obsessions, despite its obfuscated word origin in the 1920s. Zines have more in common with books than magazines, and can be as off the cuff as they can be bereft of highfalutin ideas. A zine showcases the subject that you just can't stop thinking about. The editor's enthusiasm and unique worldview is so genuine and infectious that readers become hooked on topics that they didn't know they were interested in. A zine offers a window into someone else's fascinations without the clinical or academic distance that often comes in books or the newspaper. While zines were originally ways for fans to elaborate on their science fiction and wrestling fandom, they were later embraced by DIY subcultures such as the beat poets, punk rock, and street art. Zines are beautifully unique creatures, like dinosaurs or unicorns, only limited by our imaginations. They are a product of lived experiences and culture without the limitations of having to compete in a commercial marketplace. If someone tried to copy someone else's form or style, they simply couldn't make something as interesting or with the same levels of authenticity. Each zine comes uniquely from the person whose mind created it. Everything is distinct in its viewpoints, from Quitter Quarterly to Brown People for Black Power to Motor Booty, a zine about population control, for bands. Over the past 20 years, I have been asked hundreds of times, why are zines still relevant? Wouldn't it be much easier to post your writing on the internet? It would be easier to sit at home in my underwear and drink beer, said Aaron Cometbus, publisher of the most prolific zine of all time, Cometbus, in a 2000 interview with Larry Livermore. Making a zine was never about doing what was easiest. Today, the website Etsy features 3,000 to 50,000 zines for sale at any given time. And there's plenty more zine writers that would never be caught dead with their blood, sweat, and tears for sale on that website. Publishing a zine is about relating to a person's experience in a safe and respectful environment where they are free to honestly exchange ideas with their peers. Nearly 100 years after it began, it remains a subculture within a sea of other subcultures. In 2011, Time magazine reported about highbrow magazine creatives congregating in a ritzy New York City bar for a zine release party. Their zines reflected their passions divorced from a world of deadlines and doldrums. Time cited a 20-year peak in zine publishing activity. When staff writer Meredith Melnick asked the creatives why, Vanity Fair's digital design editor Hamish Robertson spelled it out that, "I'm the biggest fan of print in the boundaries that it creates, especially because my day job is working on the web. Too many people think that you can just let the page get longer and longer on a website, and while that's true, it doesn't always make it better." Katie Hagel of White Elephants explained, "There's a pleasure in making it difficult for yourself. Other people appreciate it, and it appeals to them when you explain, 'I sewed this together.'" Claire Heslop, creator of The Sun Shines on It Twice, quit blogging to return to zine making, explaining to the Winnipeg Free Press, "Blogging didn't really work for me. I didn't get any enjoyment out of it. It didn't feel satisfying. It's not the same as having a real, small, colorful and crazy interactive piece of something that somebody made by hand for you." In an interview with ABC News in Melbourne, Australia, Thomas Blatchford, a volunteer.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.